If you have studied a foreign language, you probably made flashcards. Learning science has proven that the spaced retrieval practice using flashcards is very effective. In this video, I am going to show you how to make flashcards with a word you have looked up while reading books on Kindle. I'm going to use a flashcard app called Anki. The Anki app is a very powerful free program that incorporates spaced retrieval practice. This is what the Anki flashcards I'm going to make look like. You have a word, its pronunciation, and its usage from the book in Kindle on the front side of the card. When you click Show Answer, you get the definition and you can decide how soon you want to review the word. We are going to pull the words and their usage from Kindle so that you don't have to type manually or copy and paste from a website. And we are going to pull the pronunciations and definitions from a dictionary using API. First, let's look at Kindle. When you read a book using Kindle, you can look up any word. Just press and hold the word, then release to see the definition. This is very helpful by itself. And your Kindle will remember the words you have looked up. If you go to Vocabulary Builder on your Kindle, you can see the flashcards with the word you have looked up. If you click any word, it shows the definition and usage from the book. But the only option you have here is either delete or mastered, and it's not so useful. This is where the Anki app comes in. First, let's export the vocabulary list from your Kindle so that we can import it to Anki. First, connect your Kindle to your computer and double-click the Kindle icon. Then, look for a file called VocabDB. You can move it to your desktop if you want. Then, go to the website Kindle Vocabulary Builder Export for Free, created by Henry Wang. Then click the button, Try It Now. Upload your VocabDB file. Download the file, then open the file with Excel. Here, you can see the list of words you have looked up, how many times you have looked them up, their usage, the book titles, and the authors. So if you want, you can prioritize the words you looked up more frequently. Unfortunately, Kindle does not export the definitions, so we need to add them later. In this video, we are going to use the columns for words and usage. So I am going to delete the other columns and also the first row. Then save this file as a CSV file so that Anki can import it. Go to Save As and choose CSV file. Now let's look at the Anki app. If you have not downloaded the program, you can do so from the Anki website. I have already installed it, so I'm going to just open it up. First, we are going to create a new note type. Let's review what we want. On the front side of the card, we want to have word and usage. On the back of the card, we want definition. These are called fields. So we need three fields in total: word, usage, and definition. Anki comes with some note types. If you go to Add and look up type, you can see some note types there. If you select Basic and click Fields, you can see that this note type has two fields, front and back. We need one more field. So let's create a new note type with those three fields. To create a new note type, go to Tools and Manage Note Types. So let's create a new note type based on this basic note type. To do that, click Add and Add Basic and then click OK. Name the note type. For now, I am going to name it Demo and then click OK. Let's add a new field to this new note type. Select the note type you just created, in my case Demo, then click Fields. Let's rename these fields so that we can recognize them more easily. Select one front, click Rename, and then type Word. On the back of the card, we want to have a definition, so rename it Definition. We want to have one more field, Usage, so click Add and add the field Usage, and then click Save. Now let's format the card. Select the note type, Demo, from Type window, then click Cards. This is what you see on the front. If you click Back Template, you can see what you got on the back. When you place text within double curly brackets, Anki looks for a field by that name and replaces the text with the actual content of the field. Let's configure the front side first. So on the front side of the card, we want to have Word and Usage fields. To add a field to the card, click the Add Field button at the bottom. Select Usage and click OK. Let's also make the text Word bigger. So I'm going to delete this and click Add Field, select Word, and then change the font size to 40 here, for example. We want to have Word on the top of the card, so move it to the top. If you want to have a divider in the middle, you can add the HTML tag for the horizontal rule, HR. Now let's look at the back of the card. Click Back Template. This is what you see. This means show me the text that's on the front side, then a divider line, and then definition field. The ID equals answer part tells Anki where the divider is between the question and the answer. Click Save. Now let's import the CSV file to Anki. When you open Anki, you see three buttons at the bottom. Get Shared. This is where you find a lot of flashcards other people have made and shared with you. There are a lot of cards for languages, but right now we are not going to look at them. The next button is Create Deck. Right now we have only the default deck. A deck is a group of cards. Click the Create Deck button. You can name it whatever you want. We will import all the words there. We are going to name it Kindle Demo for now. Then click the third button, Import File. Select the CSV file you just created. Click Open. Now the import window shows up. This is where you match what you have in your CSV file and your Anki template. For the type, you select the type you just created, in my case, Demo. For the deck, you select the deck you just created, in my case, Kindle Demo, then click Choose. We are going to keep the default settings for the next two lines, field separated by comma, and ignore lines where the first field matches existing note, so that we won't have two cards for the same word. Then we are going to do the field matching. We need to look at the CSV file. Field 1 need to be mapped to Word. Field 2 need to be mapped not to the definition, but Usage. Then click Import. Then you get this message, Importing Complete. All the duplicates were ignored. Click Close. Now let's see what it looks like. Select the deck, Kindle Demo. Click Study Now. You see the word and the usage on the front of the card. When you click Show Answer, you want to see the definition, but Kindle does not export the definitions, so we need to add them. Let's do that now. We are going to pull the definitions and pronunciation from a dictionary through add-ons. To get add-ons, go to Tools and Add-ons. Click Get Add-ons. First, you need to find the add-ons you want. So click Browse Add-ons. What you are looking for is AutoDefine. So press Command or Control F and type AutoDefine. Then you see AutoDefine. Follow the instructions on this video and install this add-on. Now the AutoDefine is installed, let's add the definition and pronunciation. Go back to the deck, select the deck, in my case Kindle Demo, click Study Now, then click Edit, then click the blue button. When you do that, you get the definition and pronunciation. Click Close. Then you will hear the pronunciation, and Progeny. When you click the Show Answer button, you will get the definition. This is much better than copying and pasting the definition and adding the pronunciation manually, but you still need to open each card and click the blue button. I would recommend that you add 5 or so new cards each day, so it's not so daunting. To change the daily limit, go back to the deck and click the gear icon and then click Options. The default is 20, but you can change it to 5 or so. I hope you like this video and then you can now make Anki flashcards using your Kindle.